Hi, I'm Razi Reis. I'm a Senior Program Manager with Microsoft Identity Division. Today, I'm going to show you how to configure monitoring for Azure AD B2C using Azure Monitor. We're going to start by looking into the sequence of the steps needed to complete the configuration. On the left-hand side, you have Azure AD B2C tenant where the logs are generated. On the right-hand side, you have Azure subscription and associated Azure AD tenant where the log analytics, which is part of Azure Monitor, will reside. The reason why you need to have Azure subscription in a different tenant is because the Azure AD B2C tenant does not have one. To begin with, you create or repurpose a user account, assign it a global administrative role, then create a group and assign that user to it. Next, within the Azure subscription, you will create a resource group, you create a log analytics workspace, and then you're going to deploy ARM template, also known as Azure Resource Manager template. In order for you to complete this step, you need to have Azure owner permissions on the subscription. Select the delegated subscription. This is a subscription that is shown on the right. It will be available in your Azure AD B2C tenant to select. And then finally, you will going to configure the diagnostic settings, which essentially going to complete the configuration for the logs to be pushed into the log analytics workspace. Now let's take a look at the steps in detail through a demo. To begin the walkthrough, I will log into two different tenants. On the left, I have Azure AD B2C tenant. On the right, I'm logging into a tenant which has Azure subscription where I'm going to be creating Azure Monitor related resources. Now, account on the left is essentially going to be my global admin account. On the right, I'm logging in with an account that have the owner level permissions. As you can see, I'm successfully logged into both tenants. Now, what I'm going to do is that on the B2C tenant, I will go ahead and create a group. This is a group will contain the user that will be used later on during the configuration. I will go ahead and give it a name. I will add member, so I will add an account with global administrator permission. Select create. Next, I will go ahead and add a new log analytics workspace to it. I will go ahead and create add. Search for log analytics workspace, create, give it a friendly name. All right. And finally, press create. Now this will take a few moments. We're going to wait until it's done. As you can see, we now have our resource group, which contains log analytics workspace. For the next step, we're going to deploy Azure ARM template. For that, I'm going to open a new tab. I'm going to use a shortcut to get to the Git repo. It's aka.ms/b2ccm. Now scroll down and there's a link, deploy to Azure. Now click on this link. It's essentially going to go to the Azure portal. Since we already logged in using a valid account, it's basically going to display the custom deployment. Now, what we need to do, we need to customize some of the parameters to match our environment. That's what we're going to do next. In order for you to customize the parameters, click on Edit Parameters. Here you will find all the parameters that we need to customize. Essentially, this ARM deployment is telling the subscription to project the resource group outside the subscription into Azure AD B2C. And that's what this information is for. We start by looking into the MSV offer name. This is essentially a name of the offer or the service being provided. So we're going to give it a friendly name. Next, we're going to provide a description. Then we have managed by tenant ID. This is going to be the tenant ID, also known as the directory ID for Azure AD B2C. In order for us to get this, we're going to go into the Azure AD B2C, click on home, Azure Active Directory, and we're going to have the tenant ID here, copy it and paste. Next, we're going to provide the principal ID. This is the ID of the group that we created and added the user to it. We're going to go home, groups, copy the object ID, place it over here. The role definition ID is already populated. This is the Azure role definition for contributed role. The contributed role is the minimal role that is needed for this deployment to be successful. Also, you can customize the principal ID display name. I will choose it as is. And finally, and most importantly, I'm going to go and replace the resource group name with the name of our resource group. After you finish customizing the parameters, go ahead and click Review plus Create. This will give you an opportunity to check all the settings and customizations and click Create. Now this may take a few moments, so we're going to pause and come back when the deployment is finished. Notice that our deployment is successful. Next, what we're going to do is that we're going to go to Azure AD B2C tenant and perform the steps needed to complete the setup. In the Azure AD B2C tenant, go ahead and click on Directory plus Subscription option. And notice we have Current plus Delegated Directories option here. If we click on the dropdown, notice that the Northwind Movers, which is basically the tenant we've been working on the right here, is now available. Now notice along with that, we have the subscription, which basically contains the resource group that we need. Now make sure that you have all the selections and finally click Close. As a final step, we're going to configure which log we wanted to send from Azure AD B2C tenant to Azure Monitor Log Analytics. In order for us to do that, we need to go back to the home, select Azure Active Directory. Under Monitoring, select Diagnostic Settings. Now click Add Diagnostic Settings. Here you will notice that we have all the logs that are available on Azure AD B2C tenant, and then the destination details. We'll give it a friendly name first. For this demo, I will select audit log and assignment logs, send to log analytics workspace, and notice we have the log analytics workspace we created earlier. To save this setting, click on save. Now, this setting is completed. However, the first sync of the log to the log analytics workspace will take roughly around 45 minutes to an hour. So you do have to wait before you go and check the log analytics workspace. That's what we're going to do next. All right, now what we're going to do is I'm going to log into my Azure AD tenant where my log analytics workspace is using my Azure AD account. This is not the Azure B2C, this is the AD account. I'm going to select the resource group and then this is the log analytics workspace. Now notice that we have log section here. Under journal, I'm going to click on it. And then I will go ahead and use this pane to type in a very simple query to take a look at the audit logs. Now again, the purpose here is not to go into details about the logs, but just to give you an example of writing and running an ad hoc query. We'll go ahead and use the audit logs to write a query. This query basically going to give us the summary of all the activities that have been taking place in the last 24 hours. So let's go ahead and run it. And notice that we have a couple of events going on here. For example, initializing the tenant, get the tenant details. This is happening while I was logging into the portal. Now, the important thing to understand is you can go ahead and save this query. And this option will allow you to store the query so you can run this report on the ad hoc basis. So let's go ahead and give it a name and save. And notice that I can click on the query explorer and within the save queries you will see B2C activities, and this is the query that we can run anytime. Next, I'm actually going to show you how to add a workbook to your log analytics workspace. So let's take a look at that. In order for us to add a workbook, we'll go ahead and go to a GitHub repo, and the shortcut is aka.ms/b2ccm, one word. So you're going to go on this repo, And notice that we have multiple workbooks listed here. I'm not going to spend too much time on all of them. I will just show you how to set up a workbook, actually the first one, and then in the subsequent videos, I will go through each one of these workbooks in detail. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to right click it, open in a new window, and this will bring the JSON file that we need. The instructions that I'm going to show you are actually listed here. So I'm going to literally follow these instructions now. So the first thing I will do is that I will go here. This is the JSON. This is how the workbook is defined. I will click on raw. I'll just copy it. And then I'll be back into my log analytics workspace. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the workbooks. And I will click on new because we're going to add a new workbook. The way we're going to add it is we're going to go all the way on the right and notice that there is an advanced editor option. Click on this one. There is a sample template code here. We're just going to remove this and we're going to paste the JSON that we copied from the Git repo. So I'm going to go and click apply. And this will apply this immediately. Now, notice that we do have tabs over here, user insights and authentication, but it says that the query returned no results. And the reason is that the demo tenant that I have created doesn't really have much going on. So what I'm going to do is that I will actually show you the same exact workbook, but on a tenant where there is a little bit more data. And then in the subsequent video, I will walk through the other remaining workbook. Now, before I leave this workbook, I do want to show you how to save this because it's important to persist this workbook. So you have an option on the top, done editing. So click on this one and then you can save it. Now, when you click the save, it's basically going to ask you for the basic details here. And what you really need to do is that for example, for the title, I will call it a dashboard, but you can change it if needed. For example, the resource group, I'm keeping in the same resource group. The subscription is the same. I'll go ahead and save it. And then once you save it, if you go and click on the workbook tab, you will notice that it will be available right here. Now, what I'm going to do is that I will literally copy the same JSON again and paste it into my separate log analytics workspace where I'm reading the logs from a more active tenant. So I'm going to go and click on new. This is actually a good recap. So we're going to go and move this, click apply. And notice this time we do have quite a bit going on here. So this is an example of what you can get out of the workbooks. So in this case, this workbook provides you the distribution based on the platform. This is basically where the users are signing into the B2C policies, the browser they are using, the location. This is sort of like a map representation of that. If you go into the authentications, and this one actually showing me the client ID, which is the application ID, and total number of auth taking place against that particular app. Within the B2C. Then it will showing me the different type of identity providers. In this case, the local identity provider, which is basically the local B2C account, is the most common used identity provider. But we do have Facebook, Google, and others in the environment. We also have the authentications per policy. So you can see sort of like a breakdown here, the usage pattern here. Common failures, this is also quite important to look into your environment and see where the authentications are failing and then part of the reasons behind it. So you can see that there are like 26 failures because someone is not putting in the name right, username and password right. We also have the failed sign-in. This is the time chart selected based on the time for the past 90 days. And then we have the final, we have the successful sign-in. This is also a time chart. Again, the idea here is that just to show you that how to create a new workbook and then use the JSON template to populate it. In the subsequent video, I will walk through the remaining ones that we have on the Git repo. The last thing I wanted to show you is how do you configure the log retention duration in the log in Analytics workspace. So in order for you to do that, I will actually go back to this log in Analytics workspace that we set up for Azure AD B2C in the demo. I will scroll down and there's an option, usage and estimated costs. You click on it and on the top, you have the data retention. And notice that for the newly created workspace is set default to 30. You can change it, for example, to 90 if you want, or some other value that works for you, maybe 60. And then once it's done, you click OK, and then that will basically make it persist. Now remember, you do need to check out the pricing because retention impact the costing model. So that is something that you do want to check out. Here are some of the resources I use throughout this video. The first one is the documentation around setting up Azure AD B2C monitoring. The second one is the actual Git repo with workbooks and link to the latest ARM template for the deployment. And finally, the Kusto Query tutorial is going to help you understand and get started with the Kusto Queries if you haven't worked them in the past. To sum up, in this video, we performed the configuration needed to successfully set up monitoring for Azure AD B2C. Part of that was customizing the ARM template parameters and performing the deployment on the Azure subscription. We also look at a simple query and how to run it on the ad hoc basis and persisting it for later use. We also use Azure AD B2C logs to create a dashboard using the workbook option in the log analytics. Finally, we look at some of the resources that will help you gain better understanding about Azure monitoring with B2C. Thanks for watching the video.